Hi, Trayan. It's Thursday, December 10th, and because of this show, you aren't doing any work in class right now. You're welcome.
So sit back with your third period snack and enjoy this first segment by Maddie Butler on the 2015 marching band season.
This year's Triton marching band is going for 5 stars. The lack of home football games are giving the marching band more drive during the practices and is bringing the group closer together.
Guard has impacted me by, it's giving me a family because I actually have friends now, and I've been able to handle more responsibility, and I've been able to handle everything that's life pretty much thrown at me right now.
I think the band is working really well together as a group. I think we have formed a really good bond among all the various people. I think people feel really invested and really want to do their best for the good of the group, and I think it's been fun. I think we've had a ton of laughter and just some shared, really great shared experiences, and I think that brings people together like nothing else.
This year we have 15 members of our fall guard, 14 marching, one is out ill, and then one's marching with a broken hand. So we have more people this year. The team seems more enthusiastic. They enjoy the music. It's got a little calypso feel to it, so they're excited about that part.
So being in charge of the marching band is terrifying at first. I remember the first time I got in front of the group to conduct them, and they were all staring at me, and I was looking around at them too, and then I looked over at my director, Sue, and just went, I don't like that. And she pretty much just told me to suck it up and get used to it, and I did. And since then, it's just been an amazing experience to be able to watch everyone grow as performers and grow myself as not only a performer, but also as an individual.
This is run through one, sideline experience. This is the Triton Marching Band.
Ever since middle school, we've been told that if you want to get into a good college, you need to take 2 years of foreign language in high school.
Diego Fernandez went to the annual college fair held in the Triton Library in October to test that theory. Here's what he found out.
We are often told we need 2 years of a foreign language education to go on to college, but is this really true for all careers?
I sat down with Ms. McKenna, the foreign language director here at Triton, to talk about our high school's requirements.
In paying attention to what the colleges were hoping to get with the students that graduated here, a lot of them were expecting that students would have at least 2 years in a single sequence. At that time, that's when we made it a requirement that all students at Triton take 2 years in a single sequence.
Next, I talked to these college representatives to see what their foreign language requirements were for students entering their school.
So we're actually looking for students to complete at least 2 years of a foreign language.
We do not have minimum requirements for our foreign language.
So at the University of Vermont, we require that students come in having taken 2 years of a consistent language. Students can also test out of their first year language requirement by taking a placement exam their first week on campus.
Johnson State College has no foreign language requirement. If you've taken a foreign language in high school, that's something we certainly look for, but it's not a requirement.
Although many colleges don't require their students to have taken foreign language, most people still find it to be a very valuable thing to learn.
So why do you think it's important for students to take foreign language?
Well, I have a big picture and a more specific picture to offer here. If you look across, you know, the entire globe, we realize that we're becoming a much smaller world, and communication between countries is becoming, you know, even more prevalent. And so taking a foreign language, especially if you're going to be going into business or you expect to travel, it's important for those reasons. And I think that down the road, when you're looking at a job and your resume is right there next to someone else's for the position, I think all things being equal, the person who has foreign language background comes across as a stronger candidate for that.
Even though it turns out that not all colleges require foreign language, as many of us may believe, it is still widely regarded as a very important course to take. I'm Diego Fernandez from VTV. Back to you guys in the studio.
The Triton soccer team had another successful season this year, led by longtime coach Mr. Bradsmith.
The team finished the season with a 9-6-3 record and qualified for the Division III playoffs. Ben Volpone, a defenseman for the Vikings, put together this retrospective.
Yeah, you can be the greatest, you can be the best, you can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war, you can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock, yeah. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name,
yeah.
Cause you burn with the brightest flame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name,
yeah.
And you'll be on the walls of the Hall of Fame.
You can go the distance, you can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name.
Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the Hall of Fame.
Yeah.
And the world's gonna.
Politicians be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be jobs.
It was fairly, merrily, 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 life spot and
politicians be preachers, be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.
One of the newest trends in professional sports is to play a theme song for star athletes as they come out onto the field or court during a game.
Who could forget the Fenway crowd singing along to Three Little Birds as Red Sox outfielder Shane Victorino stepped up to the plate just before his game winning a grand slam in the 2013 ALCS.
In our final segment today, Dylan Waters wonders what it would be like if our teachers had theme songs played every time they stepped up to teach.
When professional baseball players get up to bat, they have a specific theme song played. Should teachers have specific theme songs played when they get up to teach?
I think that Miss Scott's theme song would be like pop music because she's like a really cool teacher and she's kind of like one of us. And I feel like she would listen to the music that we do.
I think Miss Scott's would be I Love It by Icona Pop because she's like young and like fun.
I crashed my car into the bridge. I don't care. I love it. I don't care.
I think Crazy Train would be a great song for Mr. Sheehan because he really needs to get pumped and energized for the football games. But he's also pulled in a million different directions, whether it's with class or planning the games, so I feel like it just suits his personality for that.
My Way by Frank Sinatra, because Mr. Sheehan does everything his way.
I could definitely see Mr. Sheehan jamming to Mama Said Knock You Out by LL Cool J. He's just such an energetic person. His personality really, I think, suits it.
So, theme song for Coach Mack, it's got to be Lean on Me by Bill Withers.
Mac's a great friend, always loyal, will do anything he can to help anybody out. Just a great song for him.
Coach Mac's a great guy, loves Triton, really commits to the community and things like that, but there are some things that he wishes he was. I'll let my boy Ski-Lo tell you what he wishes he was, and this will be Coach Mac's theme song.
Hello, I wish I was a little bit taller. I wish I was a baller. I wish I had a girl who looked good, I would call her. Wish I had a rabbit in a hat with a bat.
I think if Mr. Ellen had a theme song, it would be Bill Conti's Gonna Fly Now, which is Rocky Balboa's theme song.
I think Mr. Ellen's theme song should be Downtown by Macklemore, because it's his favorite song, and he's always happy.
Hell of a deal, I'm headed downtown. Cruising through the alley, tiptoeing in the street like ballet. Pulled up, moped to the valet. White walls on the wheels like Mayday.
I say Party in the USA by Miley Cyrus, because every time I walk into Mr. Farron's room, it's like a party, yo!
I think Mr. Farron's theme song should be Mr. Boombastic, because he's kind of explosive, and he's a straight up G.
She called me Mr. Boombastic, tell me fantastic, touch me on me box, she says I'm Mr. Romantic.
They may not make $1 million like professional athletes or celebrities, but I think we can all agree that our Triton teachers are rock stars.
Well, we hope you enjoyed our show as much as that bag of Cheetos you just downed.
For my partner in crime, Courtney, I'm Allie. Adios.
Do you know my name?
Courtney.
You're good. Retrospective. What is a retrospective? Shane Victorino. Victorino?
Victorino.
Three little birds. Three little birdies. Like when it says you're welcome, you gotta be like, you're welcome.
I don't talk to old people.
Well, maybe you should.
She said library.
That's how I say it.
It's library.
You. I'm trying to read.
Hey, you did it.
You can't talk. Well, we hope you enjoyed our show as much as that bet. What?
I'm Allie. See you next week. I'm Allie, and I'll see you next week.
Don't say, and I'll see you next week.
I know. I messed up. Leave me alone.